Hello everyone and welcome back to CLGTart channel. Today I will show you guys a tutorial to creating the scatter effect as you see on the screen right now. This effect actually you can create this both in Medibang Pen Pro or Clip Studio Pen X or even for Photoshop. It's really easy, you just use some trick with the layer mask and that's it. So here's on the screen, that is the result you will get after you finish the tutorial. And maybe you can use the same effect the way I did here with Medibang Pen Pro. Okay, I will start to do it from the beginning by creating a new file in a B file or whatever size you want. Okay, and I choose paper color here. That's a totally a new file, right? The next thing, I need a picture of the character or whatever or the object that you want to creating the object the effect. So that's why I have the image in here and remove on the background to have the transparent background like this. After that, I select on, you can simply go to Control Command A or go to the select and choose select on here, copy it by go to edit, copy, or control command with C, you already know it, right? And then paste it to the new illustration here, the illustration 3. This is a new file. Okay, I will move here so I will easy to do it and not forget and click the wrong file. Okay, here you can see that in the layer tab here I have the layer 1, copy, this is the file. Now I will duplicate this file by holding Ctrl or Command with J. You will go to this layer and choose duplicate layer. Okay, duplicate this layer. And now you will have two files of this one. Next, I will, for the top one, I will write here, rewrite the name that is string. And the original. Okay, for the straight layer here I will go to the edit and choose transform mesh transform here to, because if you use the, in Photoshop you will have the liquify filter that helps you to create the distort feeling of this one. I want to increase the size of the character in here, but not just increase the whole size, just want to have a distort filter. So that's why I will increase the number of the horizontal and vertical square here and start to drag it around to create the distortion. Is it kind of look weird right now? But don't worry about this, that's what I want to do. Okay, after you finish it, just distort the part that where you will create the scatter effect, okay? And then you click OK. Now we see that you will have two layers, one is distort, the straight one, and one is original. Now both of them, I will add the layer mask in here. You right click to the layer and choose layer mask here, choose mask selection. Same here, mask selection. Okay, for the straight layer here, I will use the bucket tool and then move it to the transparent box to fill it inside. Actually that I erase it and change it into the black color. Okay, and when you did that, you can see that this layer is disappear. Okay, and for the original, I just let it stay here. Now you will won't see anything in the original the straight layer anymore because I erased that in the mask layer. Okay, if you turn off the enable mask here, this layer will appear again. Okay, that's it. The next step that I will create a burst. Okay, here you can see that I want to create the scatter effect with the triangle. You can do it with another shape like the polygon or whatever. How to create it? I will show you guys. Turn this one off. Okay. I will use this one, this tool, and choose the polyline. I choose the fill only, don't have the line, and then choose the color is black and start to draw here to create a triangle. After that, you go to the edit and register material, choose image, and then you will have this one to create the burst. Click to use the brush tip shape here and choose the place, the location where you will save the material. Like me here to have the image material, you can rewrite the material name here like scatter. That's it. And then click OK. Then go back to the brush effect here. I only create a scatter brush here already for the old one. Now I will show you guys how to create your old brush. You will click the blank space here to create a new subtool. It will show you that duplicate subtool. Okay, whatever it is, you will have the name scatter tool. Click OK. Then you have the new brush here. Next, go to there, the button here, and then you will go to the brush tip. Click to there. Choose created material and find the one you just create, that is the scatter here, and then click OK. That's it. For spraying effect, you choose in here and choose this one in maximize, and particle density around 2 is enough. For the stroke, you can change the gap for more or less the shape. Like this, everything is perfect. You close it, and now you start doing your effect. Now in the straight layers in here, you will use the brush in black color and start to drawing around like this. Okay, and then for the original layer, you click to the mask layer. Okay, not the original but the mask one, and then you will choose the blank to erase some part here. The mask effect is really useful because you will see that it's create in the Medibang Pen Pro. I already talked about this mask here because it will help you to do everything like erase and paint something new in the mask layer and not affect to the original layer. You can see that the effect is really good when you change the paper color in here into black. I will change the layer color, and that's it, the final result you have. That's it. That's how you create the scatter effect, and hope this tutorial was helpful for you guys. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video.